See, my dad's Israeli. Still, he comes from a land of a rising sun. Everybody knows when I do it, it's done. Everybody knows when I shoe it, it runs. Everybody gather round now, it's story time. It's a true tale, yeah, no porcupines. About a kid who had hair like a porcupine, headed down a path where the glory lies, see? Back when he was a little bit smaller, his hair was a little bit longer, not quite as far back as when he was a crawler, no, but his arms were a little less strong.
What have you been up to lately, then, in the music business?
Lately I've been working on my next EP, which is the Alien EP. Should be coming out within the next few months. I got onto that through a scholarship kind of thing with Par Street Studios.
All right.
So it's like quite a big production level on that. It's all self-produced, everything's done by me apart from obviously the the mixing and mastering side and that. And then get free studio time in Par Street to do that, and hopefully that'll be out soon.
Oh, that sounds like big production behind it. But what got you into rapping in the first place then?
It's going through a bit of a rough time in my life, really. I had like a few problems, so like my way of venting my feelings really would just be to jot lyrics down. Never wanted to like rap them or anything in the beginning, but then people just said just give it a go, and it's escalated from there really.
Kids are growing up quicker, he had a bum knee to win, that's what dried him. He never gave up fighting, but you could see that kid wouldn't make it. Every day, man, his knee would ache him, destined for that same day to day. Wasted talent? Wait, no. Think that's the end of Jay? No. Intelligent kid, wild imagination.
So this EP then, it's a lot of you in there then, your personal experiences.
Yeah.
So what kind of tracks have you got on there?
It's kind of like a theme based, it's called Alien, so that's kind of about how I'm, like, people look at me, they don't think I'm going to be a rapper, you know what I mean? Like, I'm something a bit different, kind of. And then I've got a title track is called Alien. I've got another one called Trace Me, which is about, why, again, same theme, really. I'm, a bit different. And just my thoughts on the music industry. There's even a love song on there, you know.
Right. What's that one about, then?
A few past experiences, you know. I just like to write about, like just anything, and try and turn it into a kind of a metaphor really in a song.
So what's the live performances been like? Have you been gigging out there?
Yeah, I've been in the last year or so. It's like I've been booming with gigs. I've had loads of people interested, and I've got sponsors called Hush Hush Media, who get me a lot of gigs. Like, so I work with them. Been all around the country really. I've done a gigs from Bristol, Leeds, Manchester, Liverpool, Wirral, you know, everywhere I can really.
Okay.
And fighting, dreams of being published, big book signings, ran on for school every day and just dived in. 50 pages turned to 100. 100 soon became 2, but one day that fire wouldn't load, it became corrupt. And while Jake blew, the kid went nuts, roared and he fumed, entered the dragon, smashed up his room. Now in his mind, he began to accept that it just wasn't right and his dreams were doomed. Just another beat in this big blue hive, born as a worker to toil and to strive, 24/7, 365, just to buy bread and put oil in his drive. Couple years on, little bit bigger now, hair looking shorter, had a quick snip.
So the following's growing now. What's the big things coming out for this year?
Just the EP, hopefully get that out there. Obviously I'm working on the track with Dominic Dunn and Kerr. Hopefully that'll be a big track as well. It's already getting like quite a big reputation. It hasn't even come out yet, to be honest. So
yeah. And like I said, I knowing that you're a Rosh out there, so you've got your SoundCloud so people to find you. Where else can they find you?
Find me on Twitter at @officialrosh or facebook.com/ Official Rosh, Reverb Nation, Official Rosh,
just one to watch out for this year.
He didn't really want anyone to hear them. He didn't even mean for them to hit streets. Where broke out, kids made fun. Even his best friends had laughed in his face. He was at the age now where lunch had begun. He wasn't going to be the last into space. Hit up the web, ordered a mic. Asked St. Nicholas for Lord of the Mics. Made a mixtape, was a little risque, but when it came out, oh boy was he hyped. 200 copies. Shifted. Kid's self-esteem lifted. He thought maybe, just maybe, if I keep going, they will see that I'm gifted. Was this fate? Was this destiny? Why he was born with a dodgy knee? Is this why that file was corrupted? Rapper is what he always wants to be. Was it written in the stars? Etched in a stone? Climb up the steps like Sylvester Stallone? When he's in his own, he's a different guy. Like Jake isn't here. Rosh left him at home. Catch him on stage, now tearing it up. Sending out signals, flaring it up. Part of the guards that are GDR. Team on-